excited to welcome them. I have had the privilege of seeing this person perform a number of times around town, and they are running their own show for the first time coming up here on Valentine's Day. Please welcome to the stage a very funny Steve Bottomley.
Oh ho, I like the shirt. It's not a Coca-Cola t-shirt. Do you see what it says? Enjoy Co-Sailor's character. Pretty cool, right? Actually, I'd just like to take a moment to acknowledge that we're on the unceded territory of overseas Chinese landlords. Yeah, it's a pretty backwards world we live in. On the one hand, you have these properties not being occupied because if they were, it would devalue the property. And so they're left vacant for years on end until they finally overturn them for a profit. And on the other hand, you have all the homeless people in Canada coming here because the climate is better. Pretty backwards, eh? Apparently, if you were to take all the people that were on the street and put them into the vacant apartments, there'd be room to spare. Another, you know, backwards thing is when a woman bears a child, so she carries the child for 9 months. 9 months, and then finally comes time to bear the child. She probably goes through hours of painful labor and finally gives birth to the child. And after all that, the baby gets the man's name. It's a pretty backward thing. What did he do? Just get his rocks on. So anyway, I am, to go back to the housing issue, a victim of dem eviction or rent eviction, which is the words demolition and eviction combined, or rent eviction and eviction combined. The whole street I was living on, I was living in Burnaby, was slated for demolition. So there's about 10 buildings. And you know, it's the same thing actually, when those buildings are built, there might not be anyone moving into them. It's just what I said. You know, they're just gonna be left there and overturned. So it's back to, it's even a worse situation than in the first place. Now I just want to go on off on a tangent for a second. Does anyone remember the children's show, The Friendly Giant? It's got a man named Bob Hom, who won the Order of Canada before he died. And he was originally from Wisconsin. It's another backwards thing, an American winning the Order of Canada. So it had Jerome the Giraffe, Rusty the Rooster, and it starts with his foot in a small town, and eventually gets into a castle, and he starts putting furniture on the fire and said, "Oh, well, here's a little seat for one of you, and a love seat for two, or anyone who wants to cuddle up." And then for those who want to rock, I love that, a rocking chair. Well, looking for some of that tiny furniture, if anyone knows where to get some of that, let me know. Because, see, I live in a post office box. that's all I want to talk about housing for now. I noticed the English language is unique in that it has these entire long lists of words that nobody knows, just for very specific things. For instance, the list of fears. I don't think any other language has these. You've got xenophobia, most people know that one. Fear of strangers. You know, triskaidekaphobia?
Number
13, that's right. Well, there's a whole list of those, okay? Then you have the one of collective nouns for animals. So most people know murder of crows, right? Now, some of the other animals you see around here are raccoons. You know the one for that one? The nursery of raccoons. Ravens, you know ravens? An unkindness of ravens. And a couple of bears, you know bears? A sloth of bears. Yeah. Anyway, there's an entire list of those, and nobody knows them, so what's the point, right? Anyway, I can see a third one coming, which is the list of what people eat and don't eat. So you got vegetarian, vegan. Now, I don't know if you know this, but vegan is not the most ethically, the most ethical one. There's actually one little bit further called fruitarian. They will not kill a plant. So they'll only eat anything that falls off a plant, a seed or a fruit. But there's some weird ones. There's pescatarian. A lot of people know that one. Pescatarian. They will eat fish, not chicken or meat. But there's also pollotarian. You heard that? That's from the Spanish for chicken. They will eat chicken, but they won't eat fish or meat. Cerdotarian, they will eat pork, but not fish or chicken. And there's just an entire list. I can see an entire whole list of those coming. But the one that I think fits me is flexitarian. They will eat what they want, when they want it, whenever they feel like it. Well, that's all actually I have for today.